your project code and supporting file is placed under this KIM directory, and our project is almost done. And here you can also see the our database file name is kim.sql. okay, so here I am using the Linux operating system. So if you are using the Windows operating systems or Mac operating systems, whatever, so first of all we have to download the local server from Google or from its official website Jam. Okay, so okay, you can download it from here. After downloading it, you have to install it in your systems. So you can find it in your installation file in C drive, and after the C drive you can find xmpp. Under this folder you can find this Docker. So all the supporting file and folder of our project we have to place under this directory. Okay, so so this is our project file, and just copy it and place it under htdoc folder. So I have already placed it here, so close it, and after that start the control panel, Jam control panel. So if you are using the Windows operating system, then you can find the Jam control panel from program file in the operating systems. So after that you have to start all the services. Okay, our local server is started now. So after that open the Google Chrome and just type here localhost. So you can find the panel like that, and so here you can also type here 127.0.0.1. that means the IP address of the local server. That means either you can type the localhost or either you can type the IP address of the localhost. So these are the same things. So after that click on the phpMyAdmin and then click on the database, and after that create the database. Here our database name is KIM, so I have already shown you here. The database name is kim.sql. so create the database kim. So after that import the database file kim.sql, then open and then just click and go. So it will take few minutes or few seconds. So our database is uploaded in the local server. So here you can see we have already created the 36 table, and each table stores some informations. So now we can run our project. Localhost. So under the local host, we have the directory name is AIN. So this is our the home page, and our project is almost completed, and here we change the developer sections, and here you can go the admin panel. From here you can click it and then click here. So I already completed the all the module, and here you can see that suppose that the students want the bona fide certificate or a fee structure. So suppose that the CSC second sem student like Anup Kumar Mondal, okay. Get the information about the model. So get the address, okay, and the session is okay, and then set first time it will take few time. Generated the fee structures of Anup Kumar Mondal, SOETA, and is a student of 4th year, 7th semester of 3 year BTEC course, CSC curriculum, sessions are there. And this is the fee structure, this already automatically generated. Okay, and if we save it normal, then you can see. And this will generate it without the letterhead. Thus, you can print it in the letterhead. And here, you can also add the fee structure, and we can also show the fee detail of every students. Will take a few minutes because the complex logic are applied in this coding. Okay, suppose that CSC 7 sem. So here you can see here that Arunavan app. Okay, total fees, okay, admission fee. So same one and same two not required because the owner on IV is the GLET students, so already paid in up to 6 semesters, 7 8 semester due, total paid at the total due at the. So okay, now we will design a simple registrations and login form using HTML, Bootstrap and PHP. So first of all, to design the layout of the form, so first of all we have to download the bootstrap.css folder from its official website, or you can download it from Google. So just type bootstrap.css download and download it, and then download it into your systems. Okay, so I have already downloaded it into my systems. So so this one, so here the two main folders and CSS and JS, you have to copy it. After copy it, it, then place it under stdoc directory. Okay, stdoc directory. Now create a project folder, new project folder. So name it test. Then place the to directory. So after that, so if you are using the Windows operating system, so you can use the Notepad++ or whatever for coding purpose. Here I am using the Sublime Text. Sublime Text for coding purpose. Okay. So here the initial step for every HTML code have been done. So here the HTML tag will be there and head tag will be there. After that there will be body tag. Okay, then close the body tag. Okay, so all our coding will be placed under this body sections. So we will coding under this body sections. Okay, so now here we have to import our two supporting file in this head sections. So my downloaded folder is state of initial our project file. So here you can see here the bootstrap.css, and this file will we have to import into our project folder, project file. So copy this project file, just file name, copy it, and now we have to import this file into our project file. Okay, so using the link tag. So then in the href sections, href sections, you have to place the path of this file. So the path is, this is under the CSS folder, and then it's bootstrap CSS. So place the path vector CSS. That's all. .php. Okay, and then place it under your project folder so you can check it. Okay, this is our main page. That means we will coding here under this page in the body sections. And now we will design the layout like that. This is the layout. Suppose that this is the header section, and this is the body section, and this is the footer section. So every web page will have having the header sections, and this is the body section, and this is the footer section. So you can think like that. This is the division. This is the first division section, this is the second division section, and this is the third division section. That means under these divisions we have only one row, and under these divisions we have only one row, but we have the three column. Under these divisions we have on row and on column. The header section we have only on row and on column. In the body sections we have, we can see have three column and one row. In the footer sections you can see here on row and on column. So we want to design like that. So to design like that, so first of all we create the divisions. The first division is header sections. The first division is the header sections. So we will create the header first. So this is the container, and in this container we will create our divisions. So you can think like that, exactly this is like that. This is the container, whole container, and under this container we have created the on row, and each row having the 12 column. That means each row having 12 column by default. By default each row having the 12 column in the bootstrap coding. Okay, so we will create the design. So if we save it and run it, then if we run it, just type localhost and our project name is test, and then coding page is test.php. So you can see nothing is displayed here, but already our division is created, but we cannot see here because if we give the color in these divisions, then we can see it. So how we can possibly then create a new style sections and create a new file. File name is html.css. Okay, style.css. So our class name is container. Class can be accessed using dot tuples. So so we want to change the background color of the divisions. So background color light gray, suppose light gray. And then we have to import our new CSS file. We already created it, and the CSS file name is style.css. So right here, style.css. Okay. So if we write something like that, so you can check it. Okay, fine. Our division is created. This is our the first div. Okay. This is our whole container. I already created it, and under this container we want to create header section. That means we want to create a row. Okay, under this row there will be the 12 column. and so we can use the this column according to our requirement. So here in the coding sections, just delete it, and under this container we want to get the another divisions. This will contain the row part. That means the class will be row. Okay. So under this row, we want to create another div. This row we assign just 10 column. Okay, that means here 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11, that means 10 column we want to assign. So here call, and the size will be medium, and total column we have to assign 10. Okay, that's all. Under this column we want to press action part. Under this action part check it. Okay, you cannot differentiate between it, but you could change it, get an ID equal to name ID CAC 1. That means this division will be identified using ID number CAC1. Okay, so we want to style it, so the class will be called using dot operator, and the ID will be called using the hash operator. Okay, so CAC1, okay, is G background color equal to light. So here we have already tell you that we want to left the on column from left and on column from right. So how it can be possible? It can be possible using the offset. Column from going to left, the on column from left side and on column from right side. So we want to align this text. So this is our this text is under and this division. So in the CSC we have to change the text align equal to center. Okay, right. after that we want to create another division here, and these divisions will be create the two columns. One column for registrations and another column for login. Okay, so if so this row is closed and under this row we want to create the another row. Okay. Here and under this row we want to create the another column, so two column will be generated. So one will be the registers here, or another will be the login here. Under this row the two column is created, but the column size is 12, but here we assign already 10. This not be possible, so here we create 6 and create 4. This is 6 and 4 10 10 and offset mode 1 from the left, 1 from the right. So total number 12 column. So done. So change the ID CC2. Change the background color ID CC2 background color supports light sun. Okay. And CC3 check it. It's looking better. Under this row, you want to create the registration form. Okay, so we have to create the another divisions under this row, under this column. Okay, under this column we want to create the another divisions. So just copy it. Divisions, and under these divisions we create the registration form. Okay, so registration form, so create the style. Choose the color from the color code picker. Okay, so just type here and you can see this color. So this color, so this is the color code. You can write here the direct the color name, or you also write down. Divisions we want to create the form, so just copy the form from Google, just to boost the form create. Okay, we want to create the style like that. Okay, so just copy. Place it under the divisions. Okay, here. Okay. Then save it. All the label and text from here, and first change the just me. change the label size. Label size suppose 4, and then it will be 8. Another, we want to create the reset button here. So between the submit and reset, so if we type menu, okay, reset is working. Okay, reset is working. Type the tag, just copy the code and place between them to create the space between submit and reset button. Just paste. Okay, alright, our registration process is completed and registration layout is completed now. Now we want to create the login. So here just copy the code for ID and password, that's all. change the ID type and change the style. The color code. So this is under procedure file. We want to create the footer sections. So footer sections. So to create the footer section, the header part was the header. The header part was this one. Copy to the last sections. Okay, all right. Save it and change the background color. So our total form layout is already done.